come out to complain how she spent 4 million Kenyan shillings on a music video and she has only so far got 300,000 views. She's crying out to you guys, her fans. You need to go and check out her video on YouTube so that you watch it. The way you have supported Diamond Platinum International, don't like the same thing you should do to Akothee. My name is Juliana, and of course, this is the East African Social Television. The Kenyan popular singer Akothee sheds tears after a song video she spent about 4 million plus on got less than 300,000 views. Through an Instagram update, the Rolam singer shared a screenshot of a tweet where a user complained of paying huge sums of money to established producers only for the end product to be a disappointment. Now the screenshot reads, "This is to my young aspiring musical future stars. Believe in that aspiring producer in your hood. He can also produce great hit songs. Don't be fooled. You can pay a huge amount of money to a well-known producer and your song goes nowhere and you remain with zero in your account balance. Now, the user added, believe in that aspiring producer in your hood. He can also produce great hits. The businesswoman shared a similar experience, attesting to have learned the hard way. I, for one, as Akothee, learned the hard way. And after paying for the most expensive videos, I still have a video that I spent on 4 million and got only 300,000 views. The point the two were trying to drive home is, regardless of the producers or studios you opt for or even where you start from, what matters most is the end product and returns from your investments. Now, further pointing out that growth is gradual, but the industry has its fair share of backbiters as well. There is too much hype on these streets. Before you know it, you're broke with no hit song, no booking. Accept gradual growth. Music is hard with too many vultures, blood suckers, but keep pushing. Fans of the same opinion could not agree more, expressing the same. Looks like so many of them in Kenya have been so disappointed after paying lots of money and their songs are nowhere. But at the end of the day, if your song is good, it doesn't matter how the video turns out. And if you're in news all the time, one of the things that has helped Tanasha Donna and Diamond the most is that they're in news all the time for the wrong reasons. And because you guys, their fans, want to read or listen to stories about only the bad things, that is why every time we do a story, you run and check out their social media. So maybe these musicians should find bad stories so that they get the focus taken onto where their videos are. That is my opinion. How do you think these musicians can grow their views on their YouTube handles? You can go right ahead and give them your comments in the comment section. Your opinions are very much welcome. And of course, don't you forget to subscribe if it's your first time to find us. And give me a thumbs up if you love this story. And also share the stories with your friends. I am Juliana and I'll be back with more East African stories. Shit.